Welcome back to our China vs. USA high-tech series. This is the third installment where we'll dive into the fascinating world of marine engineering. In this video, we'll explore the incredible progress made by both China and the United States in this vital industry, from advanced shipbuilding technologies to innovations in naval defense and deep-sea exploration. These two global powers have been competing fiercely to shape the future of the world's oceans. Let's take a closer look at how China and the U.S. are steering the course of marine engineering and what that means for the rest of the world. Marine engineering encompasses the design, construction, and maintenance of ships, submarines, and other marine structures, as well as the technologies that allow us to explore, transport, and harness the power of the oceans. From advanced cargo vessels to cutting-edge research platforms, this industry is at the heart of global trade and innovation. In recent decades, the race to dominate the ocean engineering and high-tech ship industry has intensified. Key players leading this charge are China and the United States, each making significant advancements in their own right. But what makes this competition so important? And how are other nations responding to these technological breakthroughs? China's rise in ocean engineering is nothing short of remarkable. Under its Made in China 2025 initiative, China has rapidly transformed into the world's largest shipbuilding nation, producing everything from cargo ships to advanced submarines. China has focused heavily on increasing its self-sufficiency in high-tech marine technology. By 2025, China aims to dominate not only in the number of vessels produced, but also in quality, emphasizing autonomous shipping, greener ship designs, and cutting-edge deep-sea exploration platforms. Already, China's shipbuilding output accounts for over 50% of the global market, grabbing significant market share from countries like South Korea. The country has introduced innovations like LNG-powered vessels and manned surface vehicles and smart ships equipped with artificial intelligence, driving sustainability and operational efficiency in global maritime trade. One recent unclassified slide released by U.S. Naval Intelligence estimated that China's total shipbuilding capacity was now more than 630 times that of the U.S. When it comes to warships, Beijing is now outbuilding the U.S. to a remarkable degree. According to Reuters, between 2003 and 2023, China more than doubled its guided missile destroyer fleet to 42. Over the last 10 years, it has launched 23 new destroyers compared to only 11 built by the U.S. since 2017. China has built 8 guided missile cruisers, while the U.S. completed none. However, the U.S. still leads the world in military shipbuilding, including the development of next-generation aircraft carriers, destroyers, and submarines. The U.S. Navy remains the most advanced and capable naval force, with innovations in propulsion systems, stealth technology, and automated defense systems. But China is catching up fast with its latest 80,000 metric ton aircraft carrier Fujian, which is capable of catapult-assisted takeoffs. And a fourth carrier featuring nuclear propulsion might be under construction. Naval experts projected that China might possess 5 or 6 aircraft carriers by the end of 2030. When comparing the two, it's clear that while China has taken the lead in commercial shipbuilding, the United States excels in military applications and oceanic research. China's edge lies in its large-scale production capabilities and focus on emerging commercial technologies like autonomous shipping. On the other hand, the U.S. has maintained its global dominance through high-tech naval engineering and its leadership in undersea exploration. It's important to recognize that shipbuilding capacity plays a crucial role during times of war. For example, in World War II, between 1942 and 1945, Japan laid down 7 fleet carriers, completing 4 and converting 3 other ships into small fleet carriers. In stark contrast, the United States built 26 fleet carriers from the keel up and had an additional 10 under construction, including 3 Midway-class carriers. This doesn't even account for the 83 escort carriers the U.S. built during the same period. The scale of U.S. shipbuilding was a decisive factor in the war's outcome. China's rise hasn't just influenced its own growth, it has reverberated across the globe. Traditional shipbuilding powerhouses like South Korea, Japan, and Germany have felt the impact of China's increased production and technological innovations. South Korea, once the leader in high-tech shipbuilding, now finds itself competing with China for commercial orders, though it still remains strong in specialized markets like LNG carriers. Japan has also experienced a shift, focusing more on quality and efficiency to differentiate itself from China's volume-based approach. In Europe, Germany has pivoted towards building luxury yachts, cruise ships, and highly specialized vessels as a response to China's rise. So, what does the future hold for ocean engineering and the high-tech ship industry? The global maritime sector is set for even greater transformations as countries compete to lead in autonomous ships, green technology, and deep-sea exploration. China's ambitions show no sign of slowing down. With continued investments in smart ship technology and eco-friendly designs, China is positioning itself to not only maintain its dominance in shipbuilding, but also to shape the future of global shipping. On the other side, with its over $800 billion military budget, the U.S. will continue to invest in its naval capabilities, ensuring it stays at the forefront of military and research innovations. The race between these two superpowers and the responses of other shipbuilding nations will define the next decade of ocean engineering. The ocean engineering industry is a complex, fast-evolving sector that influences global trade, security, and sustainability. As China forges ahead with its ambitious goals and the U.S. builds on its technological strengths, the maritime world is on the brink of significant changes. How the rest of the world responds to these changes will shape the future of the industry and our relationship with the oceans for years to come. Thank you for watching. Be sure to stay tuned for our next video and don't forget to share your thoughts and comments below.